Rita Ferguson here with Family Holistic Wellness LLC, and the website's familyholisticwellnessllc.com, and our phone number is 937-999-2077. So what I want to talk to you about today, I ended up having to wait around for a little while, so I'm killing some time, and I'm going to share with you a little bit about exercise. And so let me ask you a question. Do you have symptoms of sickness and disease? Do you have symptoms of discomfort? Do you have things that you used to be able to do and you can't now? Do you have things that you used to be able to do for work or for play, for enjoyment, and you can't do them now? Due to what? Pain, mobility issues, overweight, faint, feel lightheaded, feel dizzy, get out of breath. Do you have things that you used to be able to do, but you can't now? So here's what happens. When we were in the womb, we didn't get to exercise. When we came out of that womb, we were tiny tots, not getting to exercise. So there was a blood flow issue. We got a little older. We got some movement. We move blood. We go off to school. We get that physical education class. Maybe get in some sports. We're starting moving blood. We maybe get in the middle school, high school. Maybe we get in some sports. Still got that physical education class. So we're getting exercise, we're moving blood, we're walking back and forth to classes, carrying book bags, so moving upper and lower body. Next thing you know, we graduate from school. We're working, we're going to college. We're not moving our body, moving our mind, moving our blood. Circulation problems happen. We move our upper body quite a bit, but we don't move our lower body. So the second we graduate from school, we are in trouble. And every day that we get older, we get less and less and less active. And so we're moving our mind, moving our blood a whole lot less. And the next thing you know, we get this wonderful narrowing of the arteries, hardening of the arteries. We get every symptom known to man and God, and we don't know why. It's because our legs were used to being moved. Our upper body was used to being moved. We still move our upper body some, but probably even still not as much as we used to. So we get horrible problems with our blood, with our circulation in our legs, and it causes us lots of sickness and disease in our body. And if we're not moving our upper body enough and getting our heart rate up, getting our body temperature up from time to time, just moving our body, then we could have problems in our carotid arteries and have problems with our brain, our hormones. And so we start out in this journey called life in the womb with poor blood flow. Then it gets better. Then it gets better. Then it gets better. And then it gets worse. 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 And so the second it starts getting worse, we have a lot of sickness and disease that comes to us. And so the moral of the story is, if you don't move your body, move your mind, move your blood, you will lose it. You'll lose your mind. You'll lose use of your body. And you'll lose use of the good things that come through the body, like harmful toxin removal, feeding and nourishing your organs, your body systems, your muscles, your bones. So some people say, Rita, my knees are bone on bone. Well, cartilage already doesn't get hardly any blood flow. And then when you're moving less, the problem gets worse. And it's really hard to heal cartilage. And so I just want to encourage you that exercise is important to move your body, move your blood, move your mind. If you don't move those things, the things that you used to enjoy, you won't be able to do them anymore. Just, I hope you enjoy recliners or couches or being bedridden, or how about death or nursing homes, or, you know, we don't enjoy Alzheimer's, dementia, fuzzy head, lightheadedness. We don't enjoy that we used to be able to take a walk and now we can't, or when we do walk, we get out of breath or we have to walk with assistance. We used to be able to spend time with the grandkids, play games, get on the floor, do different things, but we can't do them anymore. Just can't. Things that are near and dear to us, things that are important to us, when we don't move our body, move our mind, move our blood, we use them. We will lose them. Yes, that's right. If you don't move your body, move your mind, move your blood, you will lose everything important to you, and you will get every sickness and disease diagnosis